Hi, and welcome to this demonstration of ImFusion labels, our annotation software. This video aims to show some of our tools available for producing a successful segmentation of the lungs in a COVID context. To start with, data can be imported in either DICOM format or other file-based formats such as NIFT or MHD. Once it is in the database, it can be opened for visualization and annotation. The data we will use comes from a public dataset, which can be found in the description of the video. For this demo, we will try to segment the healthy lung tissue, ground glass opacities, and consolidation. The default tool is simply used for browsing through the dataset. The following interactions are available. By holding the left mouse button, the MPRs can be zoomed in and out. By holding the right mouse button, we can pan around the slice. By scrolling with the mouse wheel, we can scroll through the slices. The windowing applied to the image can be controlled in a similar manner. I will enable the histogram to illustrate the changes. To change the windowing, I must first hold the Shift key on the keyboard. Then, holding the left mouse button and moving the cursor sideways will change the level of the window. Moving the cursor up and down will instead affect the width of the window. Finally, double-clicking in any of the views can be used to center the MPRs in the target location. Moving on to the annotation, one of the more generic tools is the brush, which can be used to interactively paint in 3D. As we move the cursor around the views, we can see a preview of the area that will be painted. The left mouse button can be used to paint inside the label map, and the right mouse button to erase. Note that when painting, the result is not circular. This is because the brush takes into account the image intensities to reduce the risk of filling an undesired area. The sensitivity of this feature can be controlled with the Adaptiveness Slider. The higher the adaptiveness, the more sensitive the brush will be to intensity differences. In addition, the brush takes into account the windowing applied to the image. For this reason, it is advisable to tune the windowing to maximize the contrast around the features to be segmented. In this case, I will start with the air and try to avoid the vessels. Since the contrast is high, I can comfortably use a high radius and a high adaptiveness. The Control plus mouse wheel shortcut can be used to change the radius, and Alt plus mouse wheel can be used to change the adaptiveness. When I want to move around in the image, I can temporarily disable the brush by pressing space, and move around or zoom with the classic interactions. After moving it to the desired location, I can enable it by pressing space again. Software also keeps track of all modifications made to the label map. At any point, you can press Ctrl+Z to undo the previous changes, as well as redo them. Now that the lung has been segmented, I can move on to the infectious part. Note that this demonstration does not aim to be medically accurate, and instead should serve as a feature showcase. I will continue segmenting the consolidation. Since the consolidation is small and with higher intensity variance, I will use a lower radius and a lower adaptiveness. In addition, since I do not want to overwrite the already segmented lung part, I can lock it. Locking ensures that an already painted area will not be overwritten. Once I am satisfied with the segmentation of the consolidation, I can lock it as well, to make sure do not accidentally override it. I can tweak the windowing to make the ground glass opacities visible, unlock the healthy long part, and segment them in a similar manner. I can now scroll through the slices to verify the quality of the segmentation. Achieving a high quality segmentation will naturally take more time and effort, but hopefully this video will teach you the key concepts on how to get there. Of course, there are many other tools besides the brush that are available. However, ImFusion labels aim to be generic software for image segmentation, and not all tools may be adapted to all use cases. It is often a matter of finding which tools are adapted to a specific task. Thank you for your attention. You can always get in touch with us on our forums for questions, bug reports, and feature requests.